At Texas A&M AgriLife Water University, one of the things we're focused on is how we can save water in the landscape. One way you can do that at home is by building your own rain barrel where you can save from a rainy day. What we have here is a food grade 55 gallon plastic drum. This is made from HDPE plastic, the same plastic you use in your milk jug. This one had soda in it, but you can look in your community and try and find them from local beverage distributors. Perhaps you can find them from that had pickles in them, but you definitely want to avoid any that had any petroleum products, soaps, or any chemicals, because we don't want those leaching out of our barrel. You're going to need to get a template. A lot of times the template we use is just a 5-inch pot, but we have our 5-inch template already here. We put that to one side of the barrel, like you see there, and we're just going to trace this. So now that we've traced our 5-inch hole for our barrel, we need to drill a pilot hole. So the best way to do that is to use a paddle bit. I have a 3/4-inch paddle bit right here, hooked up to my power drill, and just drilling your hole on the inside of that edge you just drilled. The next step is to grab yourself a jigsaw. We have a special blade for our jigsaw that's specifically made to cut through PVC. These work great at cutting through the barrel as well. Simply put the blade of your jigsaw into the pilot hole and follow your pattern. Now that we've got our hole drilled right here with our jigsaw, we want to turn the barrel around and flip it on its side to do the hole that our faucet is going to go into. Now we have a hole saw attached to our drill. This is an 1¾-inch hole saw that is going to receive our bulkhead. We simply come up about 2 inches. It doesn't have to be exact. Next step, in order to get our bulkhead assembly inside and attached to the barrel, we have a high-tech piece of technology that most everyone should have at home. Simply a yardstick and a roll of duct tape. We're going to wrap it around the end of our yardstick and just wrap it around a few times to provide ourselves a little bit of a sticky surface. Now we've got our bulkhead, the part that's going to be on the inside, and we're just going to slap the yardstick on there, and we're just going to slap the yardstick on there, and it's wet. So we just simply take our yardstick, take the bulkhead, and stick that on there to where it's secure. Now we're going to drop our bulkhead into the barrel. There, we've got it. Because our bulkhead assembly is plastic and our faucet here is brass with, again, that 3/4-inch outside diameter to receive our bulkhead, we need to make sure that we put a little bit of Teflon tape around it. What this is going to do is make sure that those threads don't cut into the plastic. One of the things that people have difficulty with is making sure that your brass faucet is seated correctly inside your bulkhead so you can avoid stripping the threads. If at any time it starts getting cockeyed one way or the other, simply back it back out, make sure it's level left to right, front to back, and try again. As we tighten the faucet, our bulkhead is also going to tighten against our barrel to give us a good seal so we don't have any leaks and lose any rainwater. One of the most important things when you are harvesting rainwater on your property is to make sure you're not breeding mosquitoes. One way that we can keep mosquitoes out of our barrel is to simply take some insect netting. This is the same netting that you would buy at any hardware store for the screens on your windows. We're going to use this in conjunction with some silicone caulk that dries clear, so we can affix the netting on top of our barrel to not only keep mosquitoes from breeding inside here, but also it's going to create a barrier to deter any type of leaves or debris from getting inside our barrel. It's important to think about how we're actually going to set up our barrel to start harvesting water. There's a few things to consider. We want to make sure we put it on a level surface so there's no tipping hazard. Another thing to think about you may want to consider is raising your barrel up a little bit. We like to use cinder blocks for that purpose. When you raise up your barrel, not only do you have better access to the faucet there to put watering cans underneath, but also it raises the head pressure of the water in the barrel so it flows out quickly. One common misconception is that you have to have a gutter to harvest rainwater, and that's actually not true. If you have a natural valley in your home's roof and water comes down traveling at that valley when it rains, you can typically look on the ground and tell and see where that water is splashing. If you do have a gutter system, the easiest way to get water in your barrel is to cut your downspout. Some downspouts, you simply undo a screw and you can attach this attachment. This attachment kind of works like an accordion, so if you have some flexibility on where you want to put your barrel, simply attach this this adapter, screw it in there, and direct the water into your barrel. It's a great way to help your plants, but also make a splash in your landscape. You can harvest rainwater too. What are you waiting for?